Hello, I'm Dave Wyatt, Chief Interpretive Ranger at Mammoth Cave National Park, and I want to tell you about something that happened this morning when I got to work. I opened the door to my office, and a little bat, a tricolored bat, fell down and landed between my feet. Now, at a place like Mammoth Cave, we're not afraid of bats. We see them all the time. The problem is, it's January now, and this little guy shouldn't be out of here at all. He should have been deep underground hibernating until spring. The fact that I found him today is the evidence of something we were afraid might happen. The beginning of a wildlife disaster. The disaster has a name. It's called white nose syndrome, a fungal disease that affects bats. First appeared in North America almost 10 years ago in New York State, and since 2005 has been creeping westward along with migrating bats infecting new colonies of bats each season. So far, white nose syndrome has killed millions of bats in the United States and Canada. Scientists are afraid that some species of bats could face extinction. White nose syndrome was first detected in bats here in Mammoth Cave National Park in 2013. Since the disease usually peaks after 2 to 3 years, that means we expect to see its worst effects on our bats right about now. We think we may see bats flying in the cave, on surface during unusual months. At odd times of the day, we may see bats on the ground or hanging in strange places like my office door. Anytime we see a bat out from now till May is not good news, because that means the bat may be infected. White nose syndrome irritates the bats, causing them to wake up too early and begin using up fat that they have saved up last fall to survive the winter. There won't be any insects for them to eat until spring, and they'll likely die. White nose syndrome has no effect on human beings, but losing bats has a huge effect on us. Bats consume an enormous number of insects, many of which harm people and crops. A single big brown bat eats about 150 beetles, moths, flies, gnats, and other insects every night during its active season. That's a lot of bugs. One of our scientists came over to collect the bat I found for study. Scientists are working hard to try to understand white nose syndrome and find a way to help bats survive this natural disaster. But now the best we can do is be vigilant and make sure that we do our best to keep humans from moving the fungus to new caves. We'll let you know how things develop here at Mammoth Cave in later podcasts.
This podcast is a production of Mammoth Cave National Park and the U.S. Department of the Interior. This is NPS, your National Park Service. Experience your America.